Hi, my name is Sharon Bakker and I organise an event every month called Readings at Seksan Gallery in Bangsa, and it's on usually on the last Saturday of the month, 3:30 to 6 in the afternoon. And each time we have a variety of writers. We have fiction writers, we have poets, we have bloggers, we have non-fiction writers, and just about anyone else who can call themselves a writer. And in readings today, we had quite a variety as well. We had Jasmine Lowe, who's a poet, Sharmini Silvercano, who is writing short stories, and this is her first time appearing at readings. We had a blogger called Wolski69, who was very entertaining and very current. We had Dina Zaman, who was promoting her latest book, King of the Sea, which is a collection of short stories she's been working on for the past 13 years. We had a lady called Saba Karim, who's from Mauritius, and she's written a novel which is now available on Amazon.com through on the Kindle. So yeah, a great variety, and we have an equally varied audience for the event, and it's like a party with readings.
Okay.
Oh, thank you.
I know how
to take
a
beach. And I'm all a sticky mess. Ah. Stand up to a giant.
My name is Anima, and I'm a friend of Dina Zaman's, and she's leading today, so I came.
She's now living in Kuala, Lumpur, and she teaches law to undergraduate students enrolled in UK universities.
I'm from Mauritius.
Mauritius.
Indian descent. I work here in Malaysia. I've been here for the last 8 years. I teach law. And I wrote Humaira, my novel, because it was meant to be partly autobiographical and partly factual. And I've been writing Humaira for the last 13 years. I started the book when I was 16. And Humaira tells the struggle of an Indian lady. She's Meemut. It's from a specific group among the Indians in Mauritius. And she is from a middle class background, an upper middle class background. And society is educated. But the problem is that they are drowned in their feeling, in their sense of superiority. And what is very interesting about Humaira, I think, is that she doesn't only have struggles that have to do with feminism, but also other struggles such as her search for the truth. So she has, she undergoes all kinds of other existential struggles too. And we can also see some of the brainwashing that goes on in that society. So in my novel, I present different characters, different personalities who revolve around Humaira and who try to victimize her to a great extent. And it's not because she's a bad person, but that she wants to get to the bottom of everything. She's a person who questions herself constantly to try to find answers to simple things like why.
I'm a former creative director, you know, of a marketing and advertising agency. And 3 years ago, I had taken 2 years off to write my freshman novel, title of which is Fuel. Fuel is basically a story of a runner whose lifelong dream has been to win his maiden race, the New York Marathon. So training from the time he was a young boy, the protagonist in my story, his name is Timothy Malcolm Smith, he's been training very hard to make this dream come true, and he's always held on firm to the belief that there is no dream too big and no dreamer too small. And it is within the pages of you that you see how he actually goes about trying to achieve his dream.
Edges of his heart. He didn't feel angry or sad, nor was he in pain, but the teeth just would not let go of his heart. He asked Mark if she was sad about passing. She was bewildered, sad.
It took me 13 years, 13 tahun, which is how lazy I've been. Really simple stories about my time, you know, living Terengganu and all that. It's not inspired by anyone, sort of. I just wrote them, basically, because I was in university, I was doing my master's. I was homesick for Terengganu. And, you know, I wrote them and, you know, here I am, 13 years later.
And how the whole family is grieving over the death of father. Yes,
Okay, most of my readers know me as a boss king.
Hi.
My real name is Jamal. My Asylum, which is the blog I write, my asylum is about me, well, my alter ego, boss king, talking about things that are wrong with this country. And it's not blatantly political, you know, I don't take sides usually. Although having said that, sometimes it's not difficult to not take sides. But it's essentially just social political commentary about what's wrong with Malaysia and sometimes what's right as well.
Right.
That was taken from the Malaysian Insider. The band referred to is on the book Where Did I Come From? By Peter Mailer, a highly regarded sex education book. Maybe it's just Walski, but you know what really destroys our morals? Being bombarded and mentally sodomized 24/7 with sordid news of sexual misconduct that everyone, government included,